Okay, going back again. I got my there wasn't any plugs in my toolbox, but I did have some old XLs that, well, I told you about these XL plug wires that I have on here since about 92, and I'm sure I bought these back then at the same time, probably to try them out. I've always used NGKs. It lasts longer than any plug I've ever used. I don't care what platinum BS or whatever you spend a bunch of money on. NGKs used to cost a dollar until, I don't know, maybe like 2000. It went up to about a dollar and a quarter, and then a dollar and a half, and there might be more than that now. But that was an that one that broke, that was an AC Delco. So I don't know if I broke one and don't remember it or what. I know I never had any trouble with them fouling in this motor. Dang it. It's banging into everything. So I think we're still aimed at where we're going down here. Where are we? I guess so. Close as I'm gonna be able to get, I guess. Put my line back up here. Okay, so so let's put it back in. I'll fire it up for a minute, and I don't want to get it hot again. And we'll see if it runs okay. And I'm still gonna take these. I'm gonna take them all out now. Check them. It's got that going on with one of them. You may have more trouble with others, especially as bad as it was running. It's never run that bad. Ever, I don't think. Not since I got it rebuilt. I just had to find the hole. It's not hot anymore, so I can feel around. Oh, maybe it's on the other side. There we go. I wish I could see that in there, but my head would not go down there. Could try. Let's see. I don't have much in the way of mirrors. I'm thinking, I usually always like spray some WD-40 on there to clean up the threads. Or something like that. Rust Buster or something. And I didn't think about it, so I'm going to go get it. I'd have to get light in there and a mirror. It's pretty good trick. So I'm just going to put it back. Let's just find out if it runs any better. It's not like I could see very far in there, even if I could see anything. WD-40 should do me good. Keep the little straw on it and the final thing in. Let's start it once down then. If I can use the other end, it'll stay a little better. That's a little different too. Coming out. I think it was just blowing a little air out. I guess it's closer to empty than I thought. I didn't know about putting Rust Buster up in the cylinder. It kind of dissolves a lot of things. I didn't want it diluting my oil anymore, so I wasn't doing it. Now I've got oil on my fingers, so maybe I did some good. Yeah. Cleaned them up good, so that's WD-40. Okay, where's the plug? There it is, it's already. Now I'll take this sock rag and pump black it out a little bit. Now if I can find that spot again. Yeah, it looks, I just now thought about the gap, but it looks pretty good. I have a plug gap there somewhere. I think it's over in another tray. Yeah, it might be a little wide. Well, I am planning on getting a new one, so. I'm gonna say that's okay. For now, business doesn't always turn out. Sometimes it turns out forever. But this I'm gonna try starting it again.
Okay, let's start it up. Okay, well, it still runs rough. So I'm gonna get back up here and go on down the line. I might want to put that valve cover back, just lay it back on there. I think I will. That way, you know, I won't keep, every time I start it, I won't have dripping and I won't have dirt blowing in here while I'm working. Everything. Good to hold all that up, but yeah, see, it was doing some work there. So I don't know where to put it. Put it over there under the, still under the hood for now. Yeah, let's go get that valve cover. Go get it first, and then I'll kind of wipe off that gasket. It might look, if I'm lucky, it'll seal without even any, seal again without any, didn't get broken at all. Without any, you know, gasket seal or anything. It's so oily, I don't think gasket seal would stick to it. Unless it just fill in some gaps or something.
Yeah, well, that software would be nice to clean that up, wouldn't it? Maybe later. See how far I get. Mostly I just want it to run. Of course, you can't clean it on there. But it's easy to get to like that. I did wipe the extra grease off of where it sits down. Can't see the hole, the one hole that I can see, it doesn't show up there. I think it must have something in it. Here's my Phillips cigar. I don't think it'll go. Maybe the point's in there a little bit. I don't have those deals well. That's okay for now. Just use the ones with washers on them right now and then put them on the ground. The ones without washers, I'll drop those washers and lose them. To see what I'm supposed to do. Okay. Horns up fast. Put kind of finger tied them all down a little bit. Well, let's see. Yeah, the bottoms might be all right. What I'm doing, but I won't pull them tight. I don't want to bend it. Couldn't get them all the way that well. It was just kind of a little resistance there, so that one must be put threaded wrong. Right. Thought maybe it could be, but then I decided nice up here. No, I think it's too long. Yeah, it's not threaded wrong. It's too long. That's why there was so many washers on that one. Probably had dug it out of a bolt bin at one time. Yeah, it's pretty long. This one.
and put my hand on that valve cover as I usually do and have it. And it tried to come off, so let's just put them in all four. All four. Well, it's still loose enough that I can turn them out. Long one probably won't go down in this hole either, but at least it'll keep it from tipping up. I could go get my little deals, but we'll do that when we're ready to put it back in here. Is it starting? No. Guess I shouldn't be using this. I think I got it off of its spot too when I tipped it to see if it would. May have those others a little. Let me get a short socket. That way it won't go all the way down. If I got the long extension, so I don't really need a deep well. Sometimes they just work better. A lot of times it works, but not here. That way I can push down on it to help start it. Yeah, it didn't even begin to touch it. So it's really kind of like it's not there. It keeps it lined up. I don't think it'll leak while I'm just doing this part. Let's hope it don't. I'm going to leave that down there where I can see. And maybe if I put it a little bit different. Yeah, I don't want anyone near the fan, that's for sure. Okay, now I can get these plugs in. That's another AC. At some point, for some crazy reason, maybe these are used. These two are both ACs. I guess I'll change them out with those XL. I may be wasting my time here. Maybe I need to just order plugs. Yeah, I don't know how good those XLs are. Those XLs are. I really am anxious to know how if it's going to run okay. Then I don't even hear that noise. That's what's weird. I don't remember hearing it when I started out today. And when I started it up to back out, it hadn't been running in 2 or 3 hours. So it wasn't like, you know, sitting there thinking, well, maybe it does it once it gets warmed up. I don't think it was warmed up. I had started it twice, but it had been all spread out in time, you know. This one's more crappy looking. Now what did I do? Let's see. There. Okay. This one, I need light. The light that's down there that I'm looking into. I'm going to go down there to the light this time. Okay, can't do it. Can't do it that way. Now all that work I did to get that cord in the right place. So I'm going to help me a bit. Got the light opened up by accident. If this will help or not. It doesn't want to stay turned the way I turn it. Well, at least I can see.
That one's dark. I like those ones I kind of worn down too. It might, yeah, it's got a little bit of, yeah. The electrode is got to, it's fouled. Of course, I don't think they're, you know, my rings or anything have worn out. I don't think my valve guide seals have worn out, but, well, they could be getting old and cracked. But, with it sitting all these years on it, you know, starting only running it a few times a year, and, well, bad old gas, tell you what, would do to my plugs. So, thinking I'll put it under the magnifying glass here and kind of scrape on it and see how hard that stuff is. Pretty hard. Yeah, that's pretty tough stuff. So, oh, wait, is that electrode made different? Either it's the hard, some really hard stuff, or that electrode is like this big solid thing. I think it's just hard carbon deposit with a little oil on it to boot. Well, let's get it out where I can see it. I need to go over there to get more plugs. I guess I should have brought them over here and left them over here. Didn't think about it really. I've got two more that are cleaned up. I may end up using all those other little backup plugs. I didn't blow these out or anything. I'm gonna have to blow them out. Looks like the same plug as the others. I'll look at it in a minute under the magnifying glass. I just want to get the get them back. Get one more back in there. I'll just go on down the line. I want my cord. I'm hanging up on my cord now because I moved it. Okay, let's see. Yeah. Okay. I'm trying to look, see if I can see my knee, then I'll at least be on have what I'm doing on camera. I do it on my knee, which is okay. It's not a bad spot for me. So I'm gonna make sure that tight, and I'll do it to the other one. Let's see, that one looks okay. Yeah, and some of those others, I could just have a little goop on them, but I think they may have some carbon on them. But if I have any more bad ones, I'm gonna have. I got these two that look pretty good, just at first glance. So, we may have a wreck up here.